Hello, welcome to the Brøndby Hall here in Copenhagen for live coverage of the Men's European Handball Championships from Denmark. Clayton Lucas here with you for Group D action as Montenegro take on Croatia. For bronze medalists from 2012, Croatia currently top Group D, and they look to be in imperious form against Belarus, brushing them aside 33-22, their biggest margin of victory in a major competition. Montenegro, who've just come out onto court, were beaten by Sweden, and their performance, if it's repeated against Croatia, could spell the end of their hopes of advancing to the main round. This is currently how the group looks. Croatia with that plus 11 goal difference. Montenegro with minus 7. Zoran Kostratovic identified the fact that his team didn't get their defence right and their attacks were too slow. And against Croatia, with their speed and variety, if Montenegro play the same way, it could be one-way traffic. Croatia had the luxury of being able to rest the big guns halfway through their second period against Belarus. Ivan Tupic, captain Igor Vori, Manuel Strelic, Jakub Goyan, Marko Kopljar, and Kipo Mirka Alilovic all sat off during the later stages, allowing coach Goluza to play the second string and keep his star fresh for this game. Well, the question is, can Croatia do the same again? Or will Montenegro surprise the group leaders here in the Brøndby Hall? Well, Croatia have the same squad from match one. Montenegro have replaced number 20, Stefan Vujovic, who has failed to recover from having his appendix removed. So, number 7, Vladan Lipovina, the rookie with 2 caps and 3 goals, is his replacement. So, the Montenegro team being introduced. Croatia have already had their introduction. Croatia looked, well, just very, very solid in their opening game and looked like a team who are medal contenders. They currently hold the bronze medal from this event in 2012. They're bronze medalists from the Olympic Games and bronze medalists from the World Championships. The one thing they don't have as a country is a European gold medal. They have Olympic gold and World Championship gold. Head coach Goluza played alongside Igor Vori when they won gold at the Olympic Games in 2004 in Athens. Interesting Croatian fans, and what looks like a chef with that outfit on, doesn't he? A couple of Croatian fans. Obviously looking on. A whole host of stars, as I mentioned, for Croatia. Gojan and Vori and Kopljar all play their volleyball in Paris, France, for Paris Handball Club. Although the majority of the team actually plays in Poland for Kielce. Strelic and Losser, the keeper. Buntic, Tupic, Musa. So there's a pretty good team within the team. And they're all coming together from far and wide. So Mr. Novotny and Mr. Horacek from the Czech Republic are in charge. And Mr. Andorka from Hungary is the EHF. Mr. Villinger, that's Mr. Villanger, who's the observer. And Mr. Andorka is the supervisor. So now it's time to be upstanding, as Mr. Andorka suggests, because it's time for the national anthems. Here are the national anthem of Montenegro. We'll start with Montenegro, we'll finish with Croatia. So the anthems are over, the teams will exchange pleasantries and badge pins. This is the squad for Montenegro. Likely starters, Marko Lastica as right winger number 25, Ivan Perisic, right back 22, Mijatovic, number one, the keeper. Zarko Pejovic, number 18, centre-back, number 21. Vasco Sivilević plays his handball in Hanover in Germany. And 14, Milos Vujovic. Vasco Sivilević with 75 goals. Only 25 internationals, still a relative newbie. But much relied on for Montenegro. For Croatia, if Galuza goes with the big guns, expect to see Jakov Gojan, number 10, in defence. Domagoj Duvnjak, number 5, the centre-back. Igor Vori, number 9. Manuel Strelic, 26. Ivan Čupić, 27. And Marko Kopjar, number 8. Alilović is the starting keeper, but it may well be that Losser gets the nod. Depends how Galuza is going to attack this one. Stanovic knows it's his best team, and that's it, he has to put out. But for Slavko Galuza, he has perhaps the knowledge he'll whilst to start his big guns. The bench will come on if he can get them on. Croatia have the throw off. Playing in blue. Montenegro defending in white. Away we go then in the first half of this Group D match. Second game for both teams. It's a must-win game, you feel, for Montenegro, but a very difficult one if they are going to achieve that against a very talented and many's medal potential team, Croatia. Tanic, first opportunity, good save. Excellent work by Mijatovic to deny Croatia's first attack, and Montenegro can now bring it away. And a chance here, but an equally good save, but it's going to be a penalty. Alilović makes the save, denying Sivilević in the process, but it will be a penalty. Bit of a push from Vori, was there? Looked like it, defending in the area, take your choice. Right, first blood to Montenegro. Igor Markovic with the goal. The dummy and then across the body. Duvnjak. Vori. Having close encounters of the Sivilić kind. Kopjar gets it, no room for him, but he still gets the shot away and gets a penalty. Nicely done. Ivan Čupić with the first goal for Croatia. Sosimović getting the start over Perisic at the moment, number 24 with the ball. Pejovic. Sivilević gets it back, does, and now coming in off the wing is Lasica. And a seat up. But no one can get the ball through to Rekčević. Nothing doing for Markovic at the moment, out on the wing, top corner. Oh, that one just squeaks through. Shot to nothing. Marko Simović took his chance. Montenegro fans very happy. Didn't look to be ending on. Very quick shot before the defence could close him down. And Croatia's attack comes to nothing, so this is good for Montenegro in these first few minutes. Whether or not they can play like this for another 57 remains to be seen. Oh, it's snatched. Vori's onto it, takes it away. Nice ball in. Vori, goal, Croatia. They draw level. It was Duvnjak who snatched it, not Vori. Vori was away. Duvnjak gets it, and he gives it to Tupic, who fires it to Vori, and Vori fires it in. No chance for Mijatovic. Mijatovic saying, calm down, boys. It's OK, there's a long way to go yet. And indeed, there is. Jan Vukovic working together in the centre-back position. Turning 14 and Montenegro score. This is much better from them than we saw in the first game where they were profligate. They couldn't get their shots on target into the goal. They were very slow, but this is a much better performance so far. Duvnjak is tidied up, tucked up by Simović and by Lasita. Coming in is Batanic, number 20 for Croatia. Out of the picture, bottom left. Top corner, two pitch. Strelic comes off his wing, whilst Batanic is tucked up. There's the Croatian chef. Can his team cook up a win? Free, wasn't he? Well, there's going to be trouble here. Is there Duvnjak sent sprawling? Just a yellow card for Markovic. Well, it looked to me like it was Rakovic who got the card, I thought. I'm not arguing with the stats men. Vori gets the shot away, well saved. There's another yellow card here, as Vori was in the middle of a Montenegro sandwich. It's number 24 who picks up that yellow card. And Croatia get themselves another goal. Some of this ruse, his yellow card and the foul. Croatia back on level terms, Duvnjak with the goal. Simović. Krajović back to Simović, just moving it around. No movement on the line as yet, no movement from the wings either. That will come. Markovic making his run. Rakovic staying wide. Simović has been caught in the eye. There's a yellow card for Grzyn, who gets that. It's a slap across the face, wasn't there? They're real stingers when that happens. Doesn't seem like much of a touch, but the speed of the hand catches you. Brings tears to your eyes. Good movement from Croatia in defence, all moving as a unit. Not much space between them. And just passing off the winger Markovic along the line. Oh, good stop, Palilović. Duvnjak does enough to put off Markovic, who's in the area, so now Croatia can bring it away. Duvnjak with it. Kopljar has a look out to the wing. Tupic, not the best of passes, but a brilliant goal. Excellent play from Tupic. He wasn't given a great pass from Kopljar, but he just scooped it up, came inside. And even Kopljar in the way, still able to beat the keeper, Mijatovic. Good angle, good goal. So Croatia into the lead for the first time. They had a relatively slow start in their first game, and then when they got motoring, they were just too much to handle. Well, it'll stay with Montenegro. got the shot away before landing in the area. And a little bit of a... Oh. Bit of gun in. Probably would have stood. Not sure the refs would have brought it back again, and that's an offensive foul. Good defending by Croatia, holding their ground. And it was Strelic. Oh, nearly just in the area though. Foot was down before the ball were left. Tupic's hand, and now Montenegro can bring it away. Simović is calling for it. He doesn't get it, goes out to the wing. The banks though. Oh, what a clash that is! And it's a 2-minute suspension for Tupic. And he's saying, you're joking. That was a big clash. Tupic was still moving. They both got to the same point at the same time. I'm not sure there was any intent in it. Well, that was like WWE, wasn't it? It was a body slam. And Tupic apologising profusely to Marco Lasita. Oh, yeah, it definitely went into him. Oh, and Lasita getting slammed in the air and then meeting the ground very heavily. So Tupic is off for 2 minutes. And Montenegro have a chance to draw level. Marković, it will be. Scored his first effort. But he's denied at the second, but gets the rebound. Vori lucky. It was a little push from Vori as Marković had that shot. Watch Vori as this one comes back out. Ooh, he did well. He got a hand out. He didn't push him. And Lilović is gutted, made such a good save, but there's little you can do about it. We've made the save, could go anywhere after that. It's unfortunately went straight back to Marković. So Montenegro scrapping hard here in the opening 10 minutes. They're drawing level with Croatia. Duvnjak trying to find Vori again. He does. Vori can't get the shot away. Oh, it's a 2-minute suspension. Thought about the yellow card, decided against it. And Marković just could take a seat on the bench for a couple of minutes. They held him up, he was in the area. Every time the players go down, they look to the ref to say, come on, gotta be a suspension, gotta be something. Dubnyak. So a little bit more work for the players on court to do now. Both teams a man down. Just opens up a few more spaces, doesn't it? Duvnjak trying to get the shot away. He does, but he's flattened by Sevaljevic. Duvnjak tries to get it to Vori. Instead, Bitanic gets it. Has a look and the throw, but he's wide. So Montenegro survive that attack from Croatia. First third is almost over, and nothing to separate the teams. Starting to fill up here in the Bronby Hall. Sweden are up against Belarus later, and with Sweden just across the way, they make it like a home venue. 5,500, most of which will be Swedish fans. At the moment, though, Croatia and Montenegro with an equal number of followers, all of whom pretty pleased with the way things are going at the moment, especially if you're a Montenegrin fan, as they head into the lead. Nice little step back inside from Sevaljevic, and he left Vukovic hanging, didn't he? Nice play from Sevaljevic. Duvnjak out to Kopjar, out onto the wing, and a chance here for Horvat, who gets in on the action. Zlatko Horvat with his first goal, replacing Tupic. Horvat plays his handball in Zagreb, in Croatia. Coming against Belarus, he scored a hatful. Tupic back in, though, replacing Horvat. Oh, his suspension is up, both teams back to full strength. Simović, hands off. Mirkic tries to get it back to him, but it doesn't happen. It was Pejović, in fact, trying to get the bounce pass through. But it just caught Zeko Musa. Big 28. He's working alongside Gojan Vukovic, taking a rest. And now Gojan comes off. And in comes Bitanic, straight from the bench. He's denied by Mijatovic. Kopljar, Tupic, Vori, Duvniak and Bitanic all on. Along with Strelic down in the corner. And it's another goal for Croatia. Pretty straightforward this time. Marko Kopljar. Straight through. And the Paris handball player making his presence felt. Tumidis 10, one of the tallest players on court. He's the tallest player in the Croatian team. And the tallest player for Montenegro is Luka Borazan, 203. Oh, clever. Very clever play from Manuel Strelic. Goes, gets the ball, goes up, and then sees that Mijatovic has gone for the starfish and puts the ball between his legs. And it comes again, Simovic, Lasita waiting, not going to get it. Pejovic trying to pull the strings, not much movement in front of him, so goes alone, saved by Alilovic. Good outstretched hand, good reactions from Alilovic. Kopljar thinks about going out wide, goes himself, but he's denied, and oh, well, in the area, he's, what? Montenegro deemed to have held their ground, so it goes against Croatia. And then the same thing, offensive foul against Montenegro, so that equals things up. A little bit of space here, two pitch, oh, he's covered well, but space in the middle, Musa must score, but he doesn't. Great save from Mijatovic. Musa all on his own, he had all the time in the world, but he took too long. Good save. Well, it's very entertaining. And both teams giving as good as they get at the moment. Croatia leading by two, but Montenegro giving a very good account of themselves as we enter the, we're just coming to the first end of the first quarter of this game. Out to the wing, oh, he's out of play. Indeed he was. Guluza said, hey, he was out of play. And so, well spotted by the refs, and now a chance. Musa this time, surely he'll score, he does. Missed his first one, makes his second one. Again, he was clean through, no one marking him. Such a big guy. He's still able to go through the Montenegro defence. Nobody picking him up. And now Croatia with a three-goal advantage. Time off the clock, so the ball needs to be sorted out. Plenty of ways to get involved at the Euro Championships. Go to the website www.ehf-euro.com, or you can go on Twitter, hashtag EHFEuro2014, or go to the Facebook page, facebook.com/EHFEuro. So Montenegro trying to keep touch with Croatia. Need to score from this attack. Nice bounce pass in. Brilliant. Rakcevic with the goal, and the Croatian fans a little bit worried. Was Rakcevic in and down, feet down? No, he wasn't. Nice movement as well. A lovely broad jump from him to close and give himself a little bit more space, getting away from the defenders. Duvniak deemed to have made the foul. Both the referees from the Czech Republic are in the same wavelength in that most of the fouls are going against the attackers. Montenegro trying to build once again. Blocked. Savljević with the shot. Cevic gets the free throw. Away Montenegro come once more. Nice little spin. Good stop by Lilović. It's a penalty against Tupic. More perspiration needs to be cleared up. Pejovic, he went down. So Montenegro could get back to within a point here, within a goal. And indeed they do. Savljević beating Lilović. Tupic. Kopitar waits. Tanic. Body with his hand up, not getting it. Now moves inside, placed in that position by Batanic. Strelic waiting. Just trying to stretch the Montenegro defence, putting the wingers right in the corner. Oh, lovely change of hands from Kopitar. Now you see it, now you don't. Montenegro slapping it thin air, wasn't he? Marković, like, where did that go? Back of the net. Oh, that was brilliant. Good start for Lilović. He's made some good plays already. It's keeping Croatia ahead. Dubnjak, Kopitar back out to Tupic. Musa running the line now for Croatia, the big number 28. But ball slowed down so he can go off. And that sends Vori on. So making more use of Musa, Croatia, than they did in the last match. Not expending too much of Vori's energies. Dubnjak spins free. That was brilliant. Gribovic trying to match Dubnjak. And he just went completely the wrong way. That was excellent. Iago Dubnjak, who plays for HSV Hamburg, at 197 and up just under 100 kilos. That's some pretty sharp footwork for the big man. Savljević again getting one back. It's good to see Montenegro counterbalancing what Croatia are doing. playing quite relaxed volley, handball really, are Montenegro. Not too overawed by what's going on. Kopliar with the score. Just has a massive height advantage, which he uses to full effect with that effort. So, a timeout called by Montenegro. Stratovic needs to talk to his players.
Žarko, znači, možda će probati prema tebi sa tom lijevom rukom. Znači, ide prema outlin. Ok. Nastavljamo isto tako, grba. Nemoj se okretati kao suncokret. Uvijek orijentisan prema lopti, da se ne dešavaju ovakve stvari. I malo dublje prema tom lijevom beku. Vale, Vasko.
Vasko. Lijevi
bek prema sredini, znači preuzimaćeš. Druga stvar, u pozicionom napadu uvijek kad odigramo nešto što širokim ukrštanjima prolazi, spuštanje na liniju ili povratni višak do krila. Ajmo da raširimo.
Odigrat ćemo trojka.
Za koga?
Za drugog.
Eight minutes to go, Montenegro on the attack. The space opened up, and that was a really good shot, bouncing that one down in front of Alilovic. And now Tupic comes away quickly, tries to find out, was he tripped up by Markovic? Yeah, he went down. According to Markovic, a little bit too easily. Tupic has it. Alilovic. Watching on his chance for Chris on the ball. Alilovic will often wander over and have a little chat with Vaneo Losser. Oh, crikey. Well, Montenegro got a chance. Markovic scores. No time to dwell on the fact that Mijatovic had just been smashed in the face by the ball. It rebounded kindly for Montenegro and they took full advantage. Great ball from Sivljević to Markovic, who did the rest. All the while, Mijatovic was still rubbing his face. So Montenegro back to within a goal. Is that the wake up call that Croatia need, maybe? Bori back in to run the line. It's the same starting six of outcourt players. Two pitch, nicely done. Lovely reverse pass from Kopliar. Tupic did the rest. Kuljevic. Kuljevic trying to create some interference on the line. Oh, there was a chance for the ball to have gone to Lasita as he came in, but no one paying him any attention. And the opportunity now goes begging. Vori has a quick look. Who can he get the ball to? And it's passed straight out to the wing. And now inside Musa, desperately trying to get the shot away. He's fouled by Markovic, and it will be a penalty for Croatia. Musa goes off. Dubnyak gets it to Strelic. Strelic to Musa. And then Musa, being fouled by Markovic, gets the penalty. Tupic will take it. So the three-goal lead restored for Croatia. Top corner. So perspiration again, being cleared up. Very important that it is, because players can slip and injure themselves if it isn't. Could end up with some very serious injuries. So coming into the action is Mirko Milosevic, number 5. Everyone trying to get hold of his shirt. Oh, 2 minute suspension for Kopljar for pushing Milosevic away. Kopljar having a few little afters, not going to change the decision. Make your mind up. Well, he's grabbed him, he's held onto him, then let him go. Not allowed to grab him, although Milosevic dived out of the way. So Kopljar goes to the bench for a couple of minutes. Croatia with some defending to do. Milinovic couldn't keep it out. Perisic with the goal. Montenegro hanging in this match. And if Croatia are not careful, Montenegro could get a result. Still a long way to go, however. Dennis Buntic, number 21. Nice ball. And again, it's gone against the attacking team. Croatia fans don't like it. And now an error from Montenegro. Wasting an opportunity. Miljatovic had come out, the goalkeeper as well, to create two extra players in that attack. And it all comes to nothing, so Croatia just slowing things down as much as they can within the rules of the game, whilst they have the player down. So, Buntic being man-marked. Vori grabbed round the neck. And just like that, the suspension is over. So now it's Croatia who call timeout.
Si malo pred njega, Miško dobio loptu puni na. Vidite nago. Jeste me čuli?
I još hoće biti.
Ej, igrač je ruk. Jeste čuli?
Pasivno hoće biti.
Prema tome, izgubimo loptu, trčite nazad i radite mi gustoću na loptu. Gustoću na loptu radite. Hajmo.
Hajde, hajde. Hajmo zabiti, dečki. Hajde, hajde. Hajde,
hajde.
Hajde, hajde. Hajde, hajde. Hajde, hajde. Hajde,
igrača više i onda dođemo u pozicioni napad i odradimo ga na pravi način, je li tako? tako? Nema potrebe. Bukvalno da, da tebe gura, ti se otimaš i to je vizuelno ovaj, probijanje. Idemo opet da zauzmemo pozicije, tamo lijevi half malo dublje. Opet vam kažem, Kopljarka prebaci ruku ili Buntić, lijevo, desno, voli više na prebacivanje ruke. Vale, pomaži, tamo stiži koliko možeš. Ajmo, momci.
Ajde, 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 ajde.
Montenegro haven't been as varied in attack as Croatia, have they? They have, however, not squandered all of their opportunities. They've been pretty successful, just bided their time, waited for the movement. Cevic now off, making some but again, offensive foul. Defenders getting all the benefits at the moment from both sides. Musa goes. Good save. Two pitch denied. It was a slip by Buntić, and that allows Marković to score for Montenegro. All on his own. Vori couldn't get over to him. And now Montenegro are within a goal. Popliar's back on. Buntić now running things for Croatia. Tanic, Tupic, and Strelic with Vori on the line. Possession stays with Croatia. Last 30 seconds. Vori making some good moves, gets it back, but he's in the area, was he? Referee says no, can have another go, and no passive play being signalled either. They've had around about 40 seconds worth of possession. So at last the shot comes in, nicely saved by Mijatovic, and that ends the first half. Montenegro giving as good as they get. It's Croatia with a slender lead here in the Bromby Hall by 13 goals to 12. Well, not many would have expected Montenegro to have performed this well and be this close to Croatia, especially after the two teams played in their opening matches. But it is a result half-time that shows Montenegro just one behind Croatia and all to play for. Stratovic will be a very happy coach. So here's the stats. Pretty even in attacks. Croatia not making the most of their fast breaks. Same field throws, about the same look. And in fact, Croatia ahead in the 7 metres stakes. So Sebojevic leading the way and two pitch for Croatia. Montenegro, Sebojevic and Marković having a good game. And that's a worry for Croatia. Only 3 goals in the last 10 minutes. Taking their foot off the gas. And for Montenegro, well, that tells us all we need to know, where they're attacking from, down the middle and from that right-hand side. And similarly, Croatia, well, Strelic's not been used at all, has he? 0 from 0 out on the left wing. So the subs are on, having a little run around the main team to go to the dressing room for half-time tea and biscuits. And whilst you put the kettle on yourselves, you can enjoy the first half highlights, and I'll be back with you for the start of the second half. Teams back out then, ready for the second half here at the Brøndby Hallen in Copenhagen. The men's European Handball Championships well underway now. It will be Montenegro who will have the throw off to get the second half going. They're playing in white. Croatia in blue, leading by one goal. Currently topping Group D with a plus 11 goal difference. If it were to finish this way, they'd be top with a plus 12 goal difference. Away we go then. Montenegro will have the first attack and a chance to draw level. So no changes. Pejovic, Sivaljevic, Rakicevic. All starting the second half. Markovic. Same for Croatia. Kopljar. Musa, the 28, on the line. It's pinched, is it? Yes, it is. Chance here, Kopljar looks long, nice pass. Good finish, lovely goal. And Manuel Strelic with his first of the game. Didn't even have a shot in the first half. And as that ball caught the foot of Perisic, that was it. Croatia off and running, and Strelic gets his first goal. Kelce handball player from Poland. And it says he's got his second goal of the game. So my apologies to Strelic, he's got number two. I thought you only had one. Another attack comes to nothing. Another chance here for Croatia, which they've taken. And it's that man, Strelic, again. Blistering start to this second half by Croatia. Two goals and a 2-minute suspension. Well, it'll stay with Montenegro. Both the Croatian players were in the area when they played that ball. Goes to the line. Markovic is there, Pejovic. Good goal. Halilovic only helps it on its way in. Carrying that one into the top corner from Sivaljevic. Frustration for Halilovic. Painful. So a 2-minute suspension for Grubovic. Well, I'm not sure whether that's a collision between him and Bitanic, really, as opposed to what Grubovic did or didn't do, but he's penalised. Just as we had in the first half. Croatia with a suspension, then Montenegro getting one, so that team's down a man. Croatia now with their third two-minute suspension in all. Ooh, that was close. But it never got taken from the right place, full stop, and now it has been. So any impetus Montenegro may have had is gone. Goes back, tried to burst through. He was, well, he was in the area anyway when he shot that, but he was fouled on the way through. So Montenegro with no keeper at the moment. The keeper goes off. That was played onto the foot of Kopitar, so Montenegro keep possession. Low one off the knee of Lilovic. And now Croatia bring it away. Kopitar with it. Two pitch runs around the outside, gets it back. Oh, well, that's fallen nicely for Croatia. A little bit of luck. Off the foot of the post. Vori with the ball. Musa goes off. Croatia score. Back to the two-goal margin. With the way this game's gone, the furthest Croatia have been away is three goals. But Montenegro have always managed to catch up. And that's a look we've come to recognise with Rade Mijatovic. That hard done by, how did that go in, look? Did it a lot in the first game. Full space, nice ball out wide. Markovic denied by Lilovic. Great save from the keeper. And applauded as well by the Montenegro team. And that's good to see, good sportsmanship, especially from head coach Kastratovic. Good work from Montenegro, nice fast ball, opened up the spaces. Drew Croatia in, which allowed Markovic to come off the wing to shoot. Oh dear, oh, not so good for Montenegro on that occasion. Musa, oh, penalty! Threw that one so fiercely into the floor, it came up and over the crossbar. Musa goes off. Tupic gets ready to take the penalty, and oh, that didn't seem like anything, did it? But the referee spotted something. Tupic, first time, and Croatia have their biggest lead of the match so far. Stop again, Elilovic, and this is a good period of play for Croatia. They only scored three goals in the last 10 minutes of the first half, but they have come out firing here in the first 10 minutes of the second half. Nice ball, and Tupic scores. Another no-look pass from Kopitar to Tupic. Those two are linking brilliantly. And again, it drags the defender in to Kopitar. Pejovic with no choice, and that leaves Tupic free to do what he does best. 6 from 7 from him. And Montenegro call the timeout.
Okay, bilo će igrat krajnjeg I kao što smo završili prvo poluvrijeme. Miloš Vujović umjesto Gila. Tako, onda ćemo ovako. Čiko na Halpa, Miloš krajnjega, a Mila pred njega.
Može? Još jedna stvar, može. Ajde. Kad izgubimo onako glupu loptu tu na centar, ja ne mogu stići u krilo, mora mi neko od vekova
pomoći. Treba Ivan da ga stiže.
Mora mi neko pomoći. Ajde, ajde.
Za koga?
Za crnu golu.
Znači, nemoj mi izlaziti van 8 metara ti Musa. Ako ti dođe u blok Musa, nemoj izlaziti tu naprijed dok se on ne vrati.
Znamo ti točak, čkoća.
Znači, neka šutaju preko vas dvojice. Čuprok, malo samo se vidite ovdje. Da li je? Lijevo strane, uspuno. Ajmo,
ajmo.
So a 5-goal lead now for Croatia. Five goals scored in 8 minutes. Oh, that was unlucky. A deflection from the shot from Simović. Ljilović going to his right, the ball going left. Oh, goes in, but straight away is a reply from Croatia. Jakov Gojan. Stepping inside and burying that one. Again, Mijatovic, he does like a good sit down after he's been beaten. They've been few and far between for Mladen Rajevic, who plays his handball for AEK in Greece. Oh dear. A bit of a protest here. Time off the clock. So two pitches helping and just says, OK, look, it come off him, that's fine. That was nice to see. Played in a good spirit. Montenegro players knew it was their ball. Tupic had seen it was their ball, but the angle the referee had, he couldn't. Well, that was good, and good as well. The referee said, all right, fair enough. Common sense prevails. Dear. Vucevic has flattened Musa. So Croatia have the ball. Kopljar, Bori. Oh. It's Gojan with the shot. Oh, sorry, Duvnjak with the shot, not Gojan. Musa flattened. Play from Vitanic. So Croatia strengthening their grip on this game now. And the gap's beginning to open up in the Montenegrin defence. Croatia punishing them. Player in for Montenegro, number 14, Milos Vujovic. A little spin and in. Goal for Savljević. Gets the 1-2. More importantly, gets the goal. So Montenegro, what can they do? How can they get back into this? Croatia moving brilliantly. Oh, that's nicely done. Oh, brilliant. Well, Croatia's defence was looking very good. That was up until Mladen Rakcevic lost Kopeljai's marker, got the ball, and then lobbed Alilović brilliantly, didn't he? That was excellent. What they have to do, score, and then not let Croatia score in its simplest form. Good save. Kopeljai decided to go back out at the two pitch, but the angle favoured the keeper this time. Mijatovic denying the winger from Croatia. Kopeljai. No shooting opportunity for two pitch. But there is one though for Jakub Gojan, and he scores. Wriggling past Simović. Coach having a word with Nemanja Gribovic. He's looking a little bit worried. Savic. Josip Valtic from Zagreb in on the action now for Croatia in defence. That's well, it looks as if it hit the Croatian leg, so Horvat's going to have to come back. Looked like it caught Gojan. Oh, that's a good goal. Alilović will be disappointed. Oh, just took a little deflection away from Alilović. Altic tangling with Simović. Up the arc. Oh, that's a really good goal. Very well taken by Demi Bitenic. So the margin back up to 4 goals. Posts and went in. Alilović was flat-footed, not much he could do about that. Milosevic gets the goal. And Montenegro still within touching distance of Croatia. But Croatia, despite the fact that Montenegro are pressing, do look quite comfortable. That looked anything but comfortable. Croatia comes straight back. Mijatovic again with another reflective look at what went wrong as he sits down. And still remains sated. It's amazing how different people react to different situations. Mijatovic likes a good sit down and chat with himself every time he's beaten. Landin likes to have a go at anyone who gets past him, the Denmark international. Oh, that was nice. Good reactions from Alilović though. And at the second time of asking, he denies Montenegro. Croatia come away quickly. Oh, loads of space. Oh, top save. That looked for sure as if Jakov Guljan was going to score. But he is denied by Mijatovic. Ball has lost its sticky. It can be replaced, there is a spare. That was really good from Vetevic, just to have the presence of mind to do that. And luckily, Guljan denied by the post. Whistle's already gone, so that won't count. Horvat in the area before the shot was taken. Well, he got away with it once, but not the second time. Horvat with a 2-minute suspension. So to add to the pain for Croatia, the penalty is scored. Sevaljevic beating Vineo Lossert, whose first job is to take the ball out the back of the net. Divniak strikes back. This is where Montenegro need to make the most of the man advantage, but that attack comes to nothing and falls kindly for Croatia. Good save, Alilovic. And they'll be in no hurry to get down the other end. He's a long way out, and he's being hustled. And two pitch denied by Mijatovic. Montenegro, oh dear. A pass just behind Perisic, so Simovic, wasn't it? So the momentum lost, and now Croatia back up to full strength. Croatia certainly not afforded the luxury of resting their big guns in this game. Montenegro are pushing them all the way, and they are having to play at their best. Horvat, though, does have an opportunity on court. Tupic off for a moment. Batanic getting tucked up. Strelic with the goal. Fans delighted. Bit of spin. Chance again. Oh, unmarked. And that one is not going to be stopped at all. Great swing. Lovely play. Kapilja was free and through and scored. Montenegro have given it their all here. Look at that fast break goal, 6-2. They've made them count, Croatia, when they've had them. Simovic, Siljevic trying to spin past Kapilja, but going nowhere. Saved by the post. At last, Montenegro make their count. It's been a while. A couple of shots with no goals. But on the fast break this time, the ball put away by Milos Vujovic. Doesn't matter, does it? Montenegro just cannot close that gap. They are scoring, but Croatia, that little flurry they had at the beginning of the second half has set them up very nicely in this match. And with a little under 3 minutes to go, it's looking like another loss here for Montenegro. So a timeout called then by Montenegro. Is it too little too late for them? Or is there something that Stanovic can actually conjure up here?
Šta ćete vi pozovete Pole? Može li? Može li sada odigramo ovaj odlačenje sa dvostrukim ukrštanjem? Mladene, 3-4. I onda šta god da se desi što prije u odbranu, rezultat da ne pada, tako, mnogo je bitna gol
razlika. Za koga?
Za Trnogoru.
Samo Bošta igrajte, dakle, nemoj ga gurati, ne bi dobio 2 minute. Nemojte niko da dobije 2 minute. Jeste me čuli?
Jeste,
jeste na 2. Ajmo.
Ajde, završi to.
Ajde. Izda svi!
Lots of passes, lots of movement, but the shooting is wide, the time is running out. Croatia quite happy to deal with this at the moment. They're soaking up the pressure. And now Lilovic keeps the ball out. And that just about ends any chances Montenegro had in this game. Buntic with it. And despite me saying that Croatia wouldn't be able to rest the big guns, they have, haven't they? Two pitches off. Vori's off. Dubnyak's off. Kopyar is off. Second string. Keeping Montenegro at bay. And the Croatian fans now know their team will remain top of the group. And Montenegro get a consolation goal. It looks like that's not going to happen. Buzzer goes. And it is Croatia who have done the business here at the Bromby Hall. They have beaten Montenegro 27-22. And it's two wins out of two for the bronze medalist from 2012. Who will now be definitely going through to the main round. The question for them will be whether or not they can go through first. If they win their last game, they definitely will. Because they will have Sweden to play. Sweden are up next against Belarus. Confirmation then of the score. Montenegro 22, Croatia 27. Players then will line up for MVPs. Popular was pretty good. And Dubnyak as well must be a contender. And Montenegro. Mejovic worked hard, Rakicevic worked hard.
The best player from Montenegro is number two, Mladen Rakicevic.
So Mladen Rakicevic gets the plaudits for all his hard work. His team don't get any points though. So a consolation for Rakicevic. Tevic.
And the best player from Croatia. Number 25, Mirko Alilović.
And it's the keeper, Alilović, who gets the award. And to be fair to him, he deserved it. Played exceptionally well to keep Montenegro out.
Congratulations and thank you to both teams. And thank you for your attention.
So it's high fives for Croatia. They'll go back and they'll be warming down off the court, getting ready for their game in a couple of days' time. The loser will be happy, team delighted. They know they're through to the main round. Again, another competent performance from Croatia, despite the fact that Montenegro pushed them. They never really looked to be in danger, did they? Bobby, the captain, just having a chat with the guys, tell them how good they've done, and it's still not over. There's still a long way to go. So that's how the table looks in at the moment. Croatia still top. The plus 16 difference, goal difference. Sweden play Belarus next. Sweden will need to go some if they're going to overtake Croatia at the top. Here are the stats. Montenegro. 3 from 3 in the fast breaks. Croatia 6 from 9, but they had 9 opportunities. Sevaljevic top scoring for Montenegro. Tupic, Bitanic, Kopljar, Strelic and Duvnjak all getting in on the act for Croatia with a lot of goals. And a much better spread for Croatia in the first two-thirds of the game. Not very high scoring in the last third for either. This is where Montenegro got the goals from. And that little caption right in the middle at the bottom, FTO00, that's from throw-off. So Croatia had a goal from the throw-off. So I'll leave you with this wonderful graphic on goals, stroke attempts ratio in the second half. And also you can enjoy the highlights from the match. For myself though, Clayton Lucas, it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye.
That's it.